Hi everyone, Greg Meskel here for Lakers Nation. Fans of the Showtime Lakers are sure to have a smile come to their face whenever they hear someone yell, "Coop!" We are talking, of course, about Michael Cooper, a key piece of five Laker NBA titles during the 1980s. The first bench player to win NBA Defensive Player of the Year, Cooper was All-Defensive First Team five times and is considered one of the best lockdown defenders of the decade. Despite not averaging huge offensive numbers, Cooper was a strong finisher around the hoop, resulting in a special alley-oop play dubbed by Chick Hearn, the Coop-a-loop. Most people remember Cooper for being the victim of Dr. J's famous dunk in the 83 NBA Finals, but there were many positive moments. Let's take a look at Michael Cooper's top five moments as an LA Laker. We start with number five as the Lakers were looking to clinch their fifth NBA title and second in a row in the spring of 1988. LA was pushed to a seventh game against the up-and-coming Detroit Pistons. The Pistons led at halftime, and Cooper had struggled all series long in a shooting slump. That didn't keep the veteran from coming through in the clutch, as Cooper hit a couple of crucial three-pointers in the second half on the way to a 108-105 victory and the Lakers' fifth NBA title of the decade. At number four, let's jump to the 1985 NBA Finals, where the Lakers met the Boston Celtics. Game 1 of the finals saw Boston crush LA, 148-114, in what became known as the Memorial Day Massacre. LA rebounded in Game 2 with a 109-102 victory in Boston, with Cooper scoring 22 points on 8 of 9 shooting. Later in the series, Cooper helped the Lakers clinch the title in Game 6 by holding Larry Bird to just 12 of 29 shooting. It marked the Lakers' third NBA title of the decade and first over the Celtics in 9 attempts. In at number three is an outstanding effort by Cooper in the 1980 NBA Finals. While Game 6 of those finals in 1980 is known for Magic Johnson starting at center in place of an injured Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, scoring 42 points and winning, there was a trickle-down effect. With Magic at center, Cooper got a rare start that season and scored 16 points, helping the Lakers to a 123-107 victory and their first NBA championship in the 80s. Back to the 1988 playoffs we go for number two, with the Lakers meeting the Utah Jazz in the conference semifinals. With the series tied at 2-2, the Lakers turned to Cooper in Game 5. Coop hit the game winner with just 7 seconds left to give LA the win 111-109. They'd go on to take this series in 7 games, and it would all lead to another NBA championship. At number one, the 1987 NBA Finals against the rival Boston Celtics. The Lakers jumped out to a strong start, picking up a 126-113 victory in Game 1. Cooper made sure the Lakers went up 2-0. In the second quarter, the Lakers went on a 20-10 run, with Cooper either scoring or assisting on every point. Cooper went 6-for-7 from three-point range and added 8 assists all in the quarter. When all was said and done, the Lakers won 141-122 to take a 2-0 lead en route to a 4-2 series win and another NBA championship over the hated Celtics. So there you have it, a look at some of the best moments in Coop's career. He played his entire NBA career with the Lakers, leaving after the 89-90 season to play 1 year of pro ball in Italy. He's one of the most decorated players to not be in the NBA Hall of Fame, but has a clear place in Lakers history as one of the best to wear the purple and gold. Now it's up to you, Lakers Nation. What are your memories of Michael Cooper? Is there something we left out? Let us know down in the comments section or tweet at us at Lakers Nation. Thanks for watching.